Very good morning to all. Today we will discuss regarding the most important topic, that is a uterus. Uterus that comes under the same, that is internal reproductive organ. If you think about the uterus, it is the main organ, or which can we can say that it's a womb under which the baby they can grow the whole development of the baby till the 9 months of pregnancy. It's only possible inside the uterine cavities. Okay, so we will learn today about the uterus anatomy and physiology. The uterus is a hollow muscular organ that is located in the female pelvis between the bladder and the rectum. Okay, so uterus, it is like a hole, or the area of uterus that is larger compared to other reproductive organs. It's a muscular organ and that is located in the female pelvis, and that is between the bladder and the rectum. Okay. The uterus, it's a thick wall structure. The walls of the uterus, they are thick. It's a muscular parts. They are capable of expansion. If you think that during the 9 months, there is expansion of the uterus. Okay, that is the fundus. The upper part or top part, that is increasing. That is measured by the height of the fundus. So that is capable of expansion to accommodate a growing fetus. If you think about a mature fetus, that is approximately 2.5 to 3 kg. So the uterus is capable to carry out the 3 kg of fetus, placenta, amniotic fluids, cord, each and every. It is connected distally to the vagina and laterally to the uterine tubes. Okay, distal, there is a connection with the in the lower side, that is the vagina, and on both sides of the uterus, the uterine tubes, they are fallopian tubes, they are connecting. Okay, diagram we have already seen, so we are not repeating. Next, the measurements of the uterus. Okay, what is the length of the uterus? That is, this length is for the normal uterus, and this is not in the pregnant uterus. This is the normal, non-pregnant, all the measurements of the uterus. That is, length is 7.5 cm, breadth, that is 5 cm, thickness 2.5 cm, and weight, that is 50 to 70 grams. So these are normal parameters of the uterus. Okay. Next, parts of the uterus. Okay, there are mainly three parts of the uterus. That is fundus, body, and cervix. Okay, fundus, that is a top of the uterus. Okay. It is above the entry point of the uterine tubes. Okay. So fundus, that is a top and dome shaped area, that is between the two uterine tubes, and the connection where the uterine tubes and the uterus, they both, they are attached, that is known as the cornua. Next, the body, usual sites for implantation of the blastocyst. The blastocyst, that is a structure that is developed after the fertilization, and on the 4th to 5th day, the structure which is known, that is known as the blastocyst. Next is the cervix, the lower part of the uterus that is linking it with the vagina. Okay? So there is a link between uterus and vagina, that is by the cervix. This part is structurally and functionally different to the rest of the uterus. Okay, so here, this is a fundus part. Okay, here the tubes are attached, and this portion, that is known as the cornua. Okay, there is enlargements of the fundus will be there. Okay, this between center portion, that is a body, it's a site for the implantation. The fertilized ovum, that is a zygote, on 5th day, it is known as the blastocyst, and that comes from the tubes, and they will implant it over the here. And here, that is a cervix. It's make, we can say that it's a connection between the uterus and the vagina. Okay? And at the time of delivery, the cervix, it will get dilated to expel out this baby or fetus that is growing inside the uterine cavity. Next, anatomical position. One, we already know that it's between the bladder and the vagina. The exact anatomical location of the uterus, it varies with the degree of distension of the bladder. In normal adult uterus, it can be described as antiverted with respect to the vagina and antiflex with respect to the cervix. Okay, so two main positions that you must remember, that antiverted and antiflex. Okay, how it will be antiverted and how it will be antiflex, that is antiverted means that is rotated forward towards the anterior surface of the body. Okay? The body that we have known that it is a center part. Okay, after the fundus, between the below the fundus, that is a body. So it is rotated forward towards the anterior surface of the body. And sex, that is antiflex, that is flex towards the anterior surface of the body. Okay. These are the two positions, antiverted and antiflex. Antiverted, that is rotated forward towards the anterior surface of the body, and antiflex, flex towards the anterior surface of the body. Thus, the uterus is normally lies immediately posterior superior to the bladder and anterior to the rectum. Okay, in the diagram, you can see that this is a uterus. Here the bladder will be there. At the end, there is a urethra. This will be a vagina. Then the rectum. Okay, so this is a position of the uterus. Okay, it's between bladder and rectum. And the lower side, there will be a vagina. Next, layers of the uterus. Okay, there are mainly three layers of the uterus. That is endometrium, myometrium, and perimetrium or peritoneum. So the fundus and the body of the uterus, they are composed of three tissue layers, because that's a muscular organ. First, that is a peritoneum. Peritoneum, it is a double layer membrane that is continue with the abdominal peritoneum. Okay? Peritoneum, that is uppermost layer, or we can say that it's a double layer membrane that is continue with the abdominal peritoneum. And it is also known as the perimetrium. Next, that is a myometrium. Myometrium, it is a thick, smooth muscular layer. The cells of this layer, they undergo hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Hypertrophy, that is increased number of the cells. Hyperplasia, increased size of the cells during the pregnancy in preparation to expel the fetus at the birth. And next, that is endometrium, the inner muscular membrane that is lining the uterus. Endometrium, that is if the pregnant uterus will be there. Means if a lady is pregnant, then her endometrium is known as the decidua. Okay, so decidua is nothing but that is endometrium of the pregnant uterus. So three layers, endometrium, there are two divisions that we will see later, but remind three layers, that is endometrium, myometrium, and perimetrium or peritoneum. Okay, perimetrium, that is outer double layers, that is continue with the abdominal perimetrium, abdominal peritoneum. Myometrium, it's a thick smooth muscle layers. Myometrium that undergo hypertrophy and hyperplasia during the pregnancy. Endometrium, that is inner muscular membrane that lining the uterus. Okay, remember the decidua. The decidua, it's nothing but it is the endometrium of the pregnant uterus, and it can be further subdivided into two main parts, that is deep stratum basalis and superficial stratum functionalis. Okay. What is these two structures? Okay, changes, they are little throughout the menstrual cycle, and this temporary structures is not shed at the menstruation. Second layer, that is superficial stratum functionalis. They are proliferate in response to the estrogen and become secretory in response to the progesterone. is shed during the menstruation and regenerates from the cells in the stratum basalis layers. Okay, so these two basic cell structure, deep stratum basalis and superficial stratum functionalis. Next, ligaments. Ligaments, we have discussed the overall ligaments. The function of the ligaments is to support the organ, to hold them in a proper position. So ligaments, that is the tone of the pelvic floor, they provide the primary support for the uterus. Some ligaments, they provide further support and they securing the uterus in the place. Okay, so here the pelvic floor ligaments, they will have to provide support to the uterus to hold in the proper place and position. How many ligaments will be there? Then there is a broad ligament, round ligament, ovarian ligaments, cardinal ligaments and uterosacral ligaments. Okay, remember at least the name of the ligaments, that is broad, round, ovarian, cardinal and uterosacral. First, that is a broad ligaments. Okay, this is a double layer of the peritoneum. They are attaching the sides of the uterus to the pelvis. So functions of the broad ligaments, they attach the sides of the uterus, means the lining of the uterus, to the pelvis. It acts as a mesentery for the uterus and contributes to maintaining it in the position. It acts as a mesentery. Mesentery, that means they are the folds of the peritoneum. We are attached to the posterior wall of the abdomen to hold it in the position and contributes to maintain it in a proper position and proper placements. If they are not in proper position, then one condition that is arises that you may have seen, that is a uterine prolapse. The uterus that is displaced from the normal position, that is known as the uterine prolapse. We'll see in detail afterwards. Next is the round ligaments. They are remnants of cuberniculum, that is a cord-like structure that connects the two parts. They are extending from uterine horns to the labia majora via the inguinal canal and functions to maintain the antevertate position of the uterus. Antevertate, that is anteriorly rotated towards the body. Okay. So round ligaments, they are the remnants, they are of the cuberniculi, that is a cord-like structure which connects two parts. If you see in the umbilical cord, then it is connecting two parts, that is a placenta and a baby. So this round ligaments, they are also that same like structure. They are extending from the uterine horns to the labia majora via the inguinal canal and it functions to maintain the antevertate position. Next is the ovarian ligaments. Okay, they joins the ovaries to the uterus. Next, cardinal ligaments, they are located at the base of the broad ligaments and the cardinal ligaments, they extend from the cervix to the lateral pelvic walls and it contains the uterine arteries and veins in addition to providing support to the uterus. And last, uterosacral ligaments, they extend from the cervix to the sacrum and it provides support to the uterus. Okay, so these are the ligaments. First, that is a broad ligaments, they are on the sides of the uterus. Round ligaments, they are cord-like structures, extend from uterine horns to the majora. Ovarian, they joins the ovaries to the uterus. Cardinal ligaments, at the base of the broad ligaments. And last, uterosacral, from the cervix to the sacrum. Here you can see that this all, they are the ligamentous structures. Your round ligaments, your bladder will be there, tubes will be there. So this all the things that is holding the position with the help of the ligaments. Next, the supply, that is blood supply and now supply to the uterus. Okay, so the blood supply to the uterus is via the uterine arteries and venous drainage is via the plexus in the broad ligaments that drains into the uterine veins. Lymphatic drainage is via iliac, sacral, aortic and inguinal lymph nodes. Okay, So vascular supply, uterine arteries and uterine veins. Lymphatic, that is by iliac, sacral, aortic and inguinal lymph nodes. Next, functions of the uterus. Okay? So the uterus, the function, most important function of the uterus is good nurturing the fertilized ovum. Means it provides the nourishment to give a baby a platform, or it can give a womb to a fertilized ovum that develops into a fetus, that the ovum can develop into fetus and holding it till the baby is mature enough for the birth. Okay, that's the duration of the 9 months, or the gestation, that is 37 weeks. There is a period during which the baby, they getting enough mature that they can survive after they coming out from the uterus. The fertilized ovum gets implanted into the endometrium and they derives nourishment from the blood vessels, which develops exclusively for this purpose. Okay, if you see, the topic is remaining, that the physiological changes during pregnancy. Okay, so during the pregnancy, there are so many vascular supplies, they are increasing to provide a nourishment to a baby. That's also a function of the uterus. The fertilized ovum, they becomes an embryo, they develops into the fetus and they develops until the childbirth inside the uterine cavity. So the ovum, then first 2 weeks, that is known as the ovum, then 2 to 8 weeks, that is known as the embryo, and then fetus, 8 weeks up to the delivery. Means the up to 8 weeks to the 37 weeks or till the delivery is not there, then it is known as the fetus, and after delivery, then it is known as the newborn. These are the functions. And last, structural integrity and support to the bladder, bowel, pelvic bone and organs that are surrounding and the uterus, it act as a support. It separates the bladder wall from the bowels. So this is about the uterus. Okay, after this lecture, we will start regarding your medical surgical nursing units, that is female reproductive, and after that we will move to the obstetrical units. Thank you.